a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was a man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night as I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely. And ever since that day, I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me. Lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. He sprinkled me in pixie dust and told me to believe, believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly over the... Realized I finally had a family.
I could not remember.
Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you are my perfect storybook. I'm a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy. Home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Peter Pan, Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you are my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are now my home sweet home forever, a lost at last. And Tinkerbell, Wendy, darling, even Captain Hook, you are my perfect storybook. Neverland, I love you so, you are now my home sweet home forever, a lost boy at last.
Always I will say,
I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook.
Run, run, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free.
Okay. Poet, storyteller, activist, and also biographer. But most importantly, a renowned figure towards advancing African-American literature. The person I'm referring to is Maya Angelou. Most famous for autobiography, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, she remains a proactive leading figure within the civil rights movement, a leading literary artist whose influence can stretch to the likes of Martin Luther King Jr. and Malcolm X. Her poems discuss about the struggles facing African Americans since slavery, but also their strength and beauty, inspiring us to not only seek understanding, but also to advocate towards racial equality. Her role further comes within the play Georgia, Georgia, becoming one of the first black female writers to get a screenplay published as a film. She may not be with us anymore, but her legacy continues on, championing human rights and the dignity of African Americans. Thank you.
People in the world, but I'm here to introduce a hidden figure, Mary Jackson. About 100 years ago, Mary Jackson was born in Hamilton, Virginia, and after graduating high school, she earned a Bachelor of Science degree in mathematics and physics. And following to those accomplishments, she worked as a computer at NASA, but her true dream was to become an aerospace engineer. However, she didn't even stand a chance to apply for the engineering training just because she was African American. And back then, black people had to use a separate bathroom, and for Mary, the nearest one was 800 meters away, and that's approximately the distance of walking from Bistro to the Curve 12 times. And black people had to sit at the back of the bus and move out when a white person came, and they were mocked most of the time. She despaired, but she didn't give up. And she decided to make a change, and she never gave up. Eventually, she became the first black female engineer at NASA. Mary never fiercely but struggled for a change in front of a crowd like Martin Luther King. She was determined and she was resilient. She continued what she was capable of, and she never gave up. And as a result, she positively influenced her colleagues and they together formed a new flow of changes. She proved that changes are not only made by people who lead the way in struggle, but by people who resiliently work on what they can do. 60 years after, Black people are still treated inequitably and unequally. The tragedy of the Black man, Amir Locke, a few weeks ago shows it. He was shot dead by a group of police officers. According to them, it was a process of law enforcement. However, he was killed in his house while sleeping, and he wasn't involved in any crime at all. Nevertheless, we shouldn't stop and mourn. We should continue what we were doing. Even if it don't lead the way to confront racism and unfairness, we should keep going. There can be many Marys around us. It can be me, or it can be anyone else in the room, or it can be you. Thank you.
I'll be talking about another hidden figure. Throughout history, the accomplishments of many African Americans have too often been overlooked, particularly if they were a female of color. The competitive field of mathematics and science, which has been historically dominated by men, is no exception. Today, women make up just 29% of the STEM workforce, and only 5% of these women are of color. In fact, working as a colored woman in STEM was a significantly greater challenge in the 1950s. I have thus chosen Katherine Johnson as my significant person of color for her important contributions in the field of space exploration and aerodynamics. In 1958, NASA launched the Mercury program to push the boundaries of space travel. In 1962, American astronaut John Glenn successfully completed a full orbit around the Earth. And in July 1969, the whole world celebrated the landing of the first man on the moon. But all of these would not have been possible without the crucial contributions of Katherine Johnson and her fellow female mathematicians. Katherine calculated the necessary orbital equations that determined the success of all these space missions. She was especially instrumental in getting the 1962 orbital mission Friendship 7 off the ground, which marked a pivotal moment in the space race between the United States and the USSR. I believe that Katherine Johnson is admirable not only because of her significant accomplishments in the field of STEM, but also because of the tenacity and perseverance she has shown to achieve them. Katherine dared to become the unimaginable. Without any precedent, she trusted in her abilities and became the first woman in the NASA Flight Research Division to be credited as a co-author. Starting out at NASA as a mere human calculator, Catherine shattered barriers of race and gender with her fiery curiosity and lifelong desire to learn and grow. Just as she had expertly calculated rocket trajectories, Catherine has been instrumental in setting forth a new trajectory for women aspiring to enter the field of STEM by overcoming prejudice and gender stereotypes. After leaving NASA, Catherine spent years as a motivational speaker to encourage women to pursue an education in STEM. On November 24, 2015, her pioneering example for African American and minority women in STEM was rewarded with the Presidential Medal of Freedom.
You don't even